Hello, hello tribe, welcome back to my channel. So happy new year if you're watching it whenever this video is released. Thank you for your beautiful messages and for your continuous support, and I hope you get everything that you wish for in 2022. And today we're looking at messages that we need to hear about right now for 2022, because truly we can never make only one video on 1 year. You know how it goes. It's ups and downs, highs and lows, and there are so many stories that are going to be explored throughout the year. So my intention today is to look at what it is that you have to come across in one of these piles to know about. This could be a message about a blessing. This could be a message about what to focus on. I will see what's coming up. I haven't looked at these piles, and I like to do that, so I get as surprised as you. And pile number one is on your left, pile number three is on your right. I'll catch you in timestamps. Hello, my pile number one people. So let's see what is up with you all. As I said, I don't know if you watched the whole intro. I try to keep my intros short and sweet unless I have something important to say. But as I said before, we're just looking at probably one story, maybe a couple of stories, what it is that you need to know about 2022. This information, my intention is that this information would be somehow useful or maybe encouraging to you. So let's go. Let's see. The card that you have is self-doubt. Then you have the shaman, the medicine healer. Strong message straight away. By the way, sorry, I apologize for my finger. I did get a really nice set of Japanese knives. I'm obsessed with really good knives, and it's proven to be really good. And you have the Two of Cups. This is very interesting. So let's start the story. Let's see what is going on here. Let's see, which deck are we using for you all? Let's take this one. I truly do not remember the name of it in case someone's going to be asking, because I don't keep all my boxes. I just want to see what the self-doubt wants to say. Okay. Eight of Swords. Okay. Let's let gravity do the work. Five of Cups. So this is okay. It seems like for some of you have been going through this already, maybe in 2021. So you're going to have to filter out messages and see where you're at, because all of you guys are on a bit of a different timelines. Okay. So now what this is telling me with self-doubt, Eight of Swords, Five of Cups, and I don't never know how to pronounce this card. And it's Eight of Coins. I guess. You are very focused in 2022 on working through self-doubt. If you started this already, it's saying this is going to be a great year. And I think regardless, it's going to be a great year looking at these main cards for you. Okay. There's a lot of knowledge that you're gaining a lot of knowledge. 2022 for you is about gaining spiritual knowledge, as well as allowing that spiritual knowledge to improve you as a person. So you're using that. See, when we have self-doubt and Eight of Swords, someone is truly thinking about what it is. Just make sure you don't get stuck in it in a loop for too long. I think sometimes Eight of Swords could be a good card, depending on surrounding cards, when we actually take time to think very deeply. But then it can turn sour if we keep staying in the same position for too long, right? But you're asking yourself a lot of questions and you're working through your self-doubts. You might be even diving really deep as going back to your childhood to realize where that self-doubt's coming from, in order for you to have more patience with your own shadows, if that makes sense. Okay, so you're very serious about yourself as a person, if that makes sense. you truly care about your, I like to call them stones in the shoe, right? What's bothering you? What's not allowing you to move forward or to be patient with yourself? So there's one specific character trait that you have an opportunity to improve here that allows you to move through life more gracefully. And it seems like you're seeking for patience, peace, and just a very peaceful journey. Let's see how you're doing that. I'm quite intrigued, pile number ones. How are you doing that? What is going to be helpful? Let's ask that question. That seems to be suiting. Now I'm using the mystical healing reading cards. How are you doing that? And I want to sneeze. I don't know what that means to you. Maybe for some of you, you take that as a sign for something. Letting go of self-doubt. Okay, great stuff. Explore your ancestry. Mm-hmm, I told you, you're going back to the past. You're going back to the past. You're exploring what kind of influences you have as a human being. Let's see. I want to read this card from the book. It's quite a straightforward card, right? Explore your ancestry. But I always like to look at what the author has to say. Work on your ancestral patterns. And I truly feel that pile number one has been doing it for some time. So you are going to be reaping your rewards, okay? Your personality is essentially a mixture of your karmic tendencies and certain characteristics you have inherited from your family. What did I say? Whilst some of these inherited characteristics are extremely helpful and allow you to expand on the talents and abilities you have brought with you, other more suppressed aspects could be holding you back from becoming all you are destined to be. This card asks you to examine how the shadowy, we talked about the shadow, right? Unrefined aspects of your patterns, of your parents' behaviors have crept into your life and are limiting your growth and maturity. It seems like you guys, I want to interrupt you, cutting off these ropes here. And you're not allowing yourself to be influenced by those ropes anymore. See, there is an arrow showing moving forward, and that's what you're doing here. It seems like some of you guys are, something might happen in order for you to start doing this if you haven't just yet. Some maybe event might trigger and push you towards this path of exploration of self. Number six, number nine might be important. Number seven and one. If it's for you, you know what it means. Well, I'm saying that because I don't want people to start, you know, looking up all numbers and getting lost. Okay. If you want to do that, filter out messages. Some sentences will be highlighted to you. Some of these behaviors could include being pushy, harsh, opinionated, controlling, manipulative, domineering, wanting things your own way, constantly sweating the small stuff, self-sabotage, selfishness, playing a victim, using guilt as a way to punish, etc. To recognize these behaviors in yourself could seem a little confrontational, especially if you have spent your life trying to be as different from your parents as possible. Yet it's only through confronting your limitations that you can evolve or delete it into something who lives their life consciously and autonomously. Okay, this is great stuff. This number also, 13, might be important. I would say pay attention to your home address. If you haven't explored this just yet, I'd say pay attention to that, because it feels like for some of you, you might want to look into numerology and what it means where you live. Okay, and I don't know why I want to talk about this, but at least for me, I always paid attention to where I lived, what was the number, and what kind of vibe it carried, what kind of message it carried. And most of the time, it's exactly what I had to either go through or learn in that home address. So do your own research. If you will want to move I'd say do not be obsessed with moving to the exact number that of your liking. Just allow it to flow, okay? What I like to do, I like to kind of analyze it afterwards so I don't get stuck on something, or I do not multi-manage the universe, if that makes sense. Now, I'm excited for the shaman as well as the two of cups. Shall we dive into that? Shall we? Let's see. Pile number one. Spiritual practices. Hey, pile number one. Spiritual practices. You have a connection. This is not for all of you, to a bird, specific bird, but it seems like I don't feel like that bird is a messenger as much as it has a connection to you as a person, okay? For others of you, shells might be important, or a snake. Let's see what the shaman wants to say here. Maybe some of you have been doubting yourself in one talent, skill, craft, business, whatever that would be. If that's the case, it seems like in 2022, you see how development of you as a person is influencing your craft, what you care about, what you want to focus on, what you like doing. There's a lot of wisdom to be picked up from 2022 along the way, I'm hearing, along the way. So make it a journey. Let's see. Let's talk. So straightforward, you know, some of you might be interested in shamanism, anything to do with energy work, medicine man, I'm hearing, plants, herbal medicine. That might be important to you. Some of you, I want to say, you might go on some kind of spiritual retreat or a seminar, or you might book a course of some sorts. I'm seeing you improving. This is within you already, okay? It's in you. You are improving as a master. And it's going to be seen, okay? It's going to be seen. Let's see what we got, pile one. You have the Ten of Wands. Straight away, what I heard, some knowledge might be heavy to carry. So these are usually the people who see life from 360 angle. And at first, when people just start, you know, diving deep into spirituality and diving deep into also, you know, the hermit mode, it can be difficult. But after some time, you master. You master your craft, you master yourself. You also know how to navigate life much more. Because what I'm paying attention to here is the heart in the Ten of Wands, right? Yes, it's difficult to carry for me this wisdom and knowledge, but this is something that I love. Yeah, I'm going to have to push a little bit farther, but that's something that I love. She doesn't seem like she would want to drop those wands because that's something that she loves, okay? Make sure you have a good balance between, you know, knowing when to take extra tasks or responsibilities and when to actually take a chill pill. Yeah, this is 2022 for pile number one. It's the year of exploring your path and your mission. It's a very strong karmic year here. So if some of you haven't explored fully or haven't come across something that is your path, you are definitely doing that, okay? You are definitely doing that. And it's going to be worth a celebration. Just know and remember, let's see, bottom of the deck. Yeah, Ace of Wands. Know and remember that it's not only about one thing. Sometimes when people talk about mission, people think, okay, it's only one thing. Actually, it branches off. A mission can branch off to little things, right? Different arts and crafts and different knowledges about different things. And it seems like you've been prepared. And 2022 is when you finally bloom. But along the way in 2022, you also have other options and opportunities coming in that you'll also want to take on, right? So maybe that's why you're like, damn, like there's so much. But this is worth celebration. This is something that I'm meant to be doing. This is something that I've always wanted. Or I finally see, I'm getting, some of you might be visible in 2022 in something that you hold dearly to your heart. Something that your heart has desired for a long time. You are recognized for your passion. And I said passion, not achievement on purpose, because it seems like for you, it's much more important to do things from heart than to just be visible for some kind of business. Yes, it brought you money, but if it's not something that you are passionate about, you're like, you know, let me look for something that I'm truly passionate about. So maybe you use the, you know, the money that that business gave you and then invest it in your passion. That's an example, right? Remember how I said, I don't know, did I say that or was it in my mind? I talked about something to do with, yeah, we talked about home, right? So some of you guys might be choosing or buying a home or moving somewhere because this girl, she's like, do I want to stay here? Do I want to start something new? What do I do? But for most of you, it seems like you love where you are, but you want to improve your environment. So I don't know what it means to you all because you're very different, but there is something about improving your environment. I keep seeing this spiritual trip of some sorts, or retreat, or meeting a person on a journey, whilst you are on a journey. And maybe that person will be someone who's going to offer you or connect you to someone who has a lot of ancient wisdom. It's all about ancient wisdom, pile number one. I must tell ya. Let's tune into the Two of Cups. I feel like I might need these cards, so let me put it back and let's shuffle. Because I feel like these two are different type of stories. Let's see. You have the Ace of Pentacles. We like that for you. You have the Queen of Cups. You have the Five of Pentacles. You have the Five of... Something is changing in your relationship. Now, it could be you and yourself, right? Me, myself, and I relationship. Or it could be with someone else. The Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, I'm telling you. Let's see. Bottom of the deck. We have the Eight of Cups. Okay. And after the Eight of Cups, we have the Hierophant. It's, look at your cards. They are super effing spiritual. Look at the Queen of Cups over here in this deck. Look at this card that we started with, hey? See what I mean? So you guys are really diving deep here. And I don't know if this connection will be romantic connection or not. I don't really care, to be honest. I'm just going to call it a connection. What we're being told about here is that you finding a very strong soul connection with somebody. But for a lot of you, it seems like it's you. Because we have the Queen of Cups, and I feel like this is your vibe. She's super intuitive. We have a Shaman card here. Could be someone else. Gotta filter out the messages. But whoever this person is, it seems like there's going to be a situation where you're like, damn, like I really like this. This has a lot of potential. This connection has a lot of potential. I see it. Then something is happening where you feel like you have to spend some time on your own. So maybe there is distance then between these two people, or you feel like there is going to be disconnect within yourself. But that's happening for a reason somehow. It's going to make you fight for what you want, or it's going to make you feel a bit more competitive, a bit of a
kick in the ass, to be honest. And it could be a situation where someone's being unintentionally by the other person pushed into spirituality, or pushed into, I'm seeing a door opening. How should I sum this up for you? You connect with someone so deeply, or you recognize something in them, and that's when changes start happening. So it's like one person is able to shift the other person's either perception or influence their energy field without really knowing. And I feel like these both people have no clue. It's just the energy. Just meeting one another is going to shift a lot of things around. And at the end of the day, this turns out to be something that you could possibly have to still leave behind, meaning the person, or the old version of yourself you're leaving behind, right, with the Eight of Cups. And you're stepping into a path that has a connection to teaching. If you haven't started teaching yet, you might be preparing yourself for a teacher's role in 2022. Because you've got a lot to say. We have 555 here. 555, and the Hierophant is number 52, right? It's a really, really big year for changes, especially within and through connections. Let's talk about this Hierophant a little bit more. Let's see what is up. See, you're walking straight into the arms of this Hierophant here. Some of you guys might find yourselves in a very strong contract. This could be a soul contract. This could be business, but it feels more like a soul contract. And someone's soul is recognizing the other one's soul. Could be also a situation where one person is in spiritual field and they have someone as a client. And when they speak, I'm hearing the sky opens up. Weird stuff. Hey, I know. Don't even say. Four of Wands. I'm seeing marriage for pile number one, too. Know if that's your message or not. Or someone is renewing the vow. Your card's now all over the place. Wait. Give me a minute. You have the Hermit. You have the Eight of Swords. Yeah, it's all about spiritual stuff here. Pile number one. This is deep stuff. It's deep. The Empress, YOLO, living the best life, I like that. Let's see, why is this Eight of Swords here? Self-doubt. Why are you doubting about something here? Because you feel like you're going to have to fight for something, or you're going to have to stand your ground, and it's going to be difficult. But what you don't see, what you might not see in 2022, that you got it already. You have the Emperor and the Empress. Told you about the connection, the contract, right? Someone's definitely celebrating some kind of a contract, but it's not a straightforward journey. It's not a, you know, a smooth sailing journey here. It's more so like whatever this connection is, there is some kind of a challenge in order for someone to grow. Some of you might think this is too good to be true. Something is too good to be true. That's why the self-doubt kicks in, okay? Because we don't have any cards that talk about drama, shit situations, you know, anything that is truly, like, difficult. We have really strong cards, but there is still that self-doubt in there. So maybe that's why the situation is happening in order for you to recognize that maybe there is a bit of self-sabotage. You're like, oh, this is too good to be true. I don't know. Am I worthy enough? Am I this? Am I that, right? And I think that's when you're going to start working with the Hermit here and the Eight of Swords on what it is that you want to release out of your system once and for all. So don't have to think that whatever good is coming your way that you have to fight or something bad will happen afterwards. Make sense? Divine union here. Again, could be a friend, could be a business partner, could be a romantic relationship, okay? Whatever this partnership is, it seems like it's divinely guided here. Let me tell you. Can we know more about this partnership, please? See? Get out of here, pile one. I looked at the time when I said get out of here. It was from the beginning of pile two was 24-24, okay? Number six might be important. I remember. Look what she's standing on. That was your card that I pulled in the very beginning. She's standing on number six. I would truly dive into the meaning of number six if I were you. If you don't feel like it, you don't have to. But for those who are, dive into number six and see what it means. Now, the High Priestess is telling you that intuitively, you know how everything is going to unfold, more or less. What you might not know about, it's about those, you know, little twists and turns. But the outcome or like the main thing you already feel intuitively. So you being super guided, pile number one in 2022, comes up to number six, hey? That's why it might be important. There's a lot of ancient wisdom to be gained. And you might be meeting very important people who have a lot of knowledge in a topic your soul is driving you towards, okay? It's going to be mysterious, it's going to be eye-opening, it's going to be a lot, okay? It's going to be a lot to soak in. You're like a sponge. And once that sponge is full of information, that's when that sponge starts releasing all that information for those who need to learn whatever you've learned yourself. You're stepping into a role of a leadership of some sorts. That is for sure. Even if you're watching this video and you're like, Brigita, I have nothing to do with spirituality. I'm just interested in it. I'm just watching no videos sometimes, but I have, let's say I'm a lawyer, right? And I love being a lawyer. Interpret it in your own way. This is saying you're coming across the person who might be super influential in your field. By the way they speak or how they express themselves, you can feel that they have this ancient knowledge about life overall. Okay? I hope this made sense, pile number one. Exciting. I'll catch you next time. Bye for now. Hello, pile number two people. So I don't know if you listened to the intro or not, but my intention with this reading is to look at what it is that you might need to know about 2022. Okay, so we might be covering a specific maybe event. The cards might be talking about what it is that you'll be focusing on, etc., etc. So let's look at the cards together. I'm saying that because I'm planning to do reading like that throughout 2022. Okay, so it's not the reading that's going to sum the whole 2022 up. Okay, let's look what we got here. Wow, pile number two. Okay, starting strong, eh? Start 10 of cups as well. And the 2 of wands. Wow. There is definitely some kind of connection to the sky or the stars or the clouds. Some of you might have seen this already and you know what it means. Because I'm seeing someone looking at the clouds and they see a shape that the cloud is shaped in a way that you understand the message. Does that make sense? Let me just sit with these cards for a minute. You guys seems like, and this might be a bit of a struggle for some of you if you haven't acknowledged that just yet, but you're very good at channeling info in 2022. But why I'm saying it might be difficult because some of you maybe do not know that already, or maybe haven't analyzed it. Sometimes you think that it's just a thought, but it's actually a channeled thought. And whenever this happens, it's saying, listen to that channeled thought. There are messages coming from above, okay? Especially when it comes to your loved ones. For you guys, what's important, what you're going to be rich in, is the heart matters. Is close connections, what your heart is happy about. I'm feeling like there is a warm blanket being put on my shoulders. But you probably have been trying to improve relationships in your life, specifically a couple of them I'm seeing for some time, and you're a little bit more relaxed about how people are, what they believe in. Someone is not trying or is going to stop trying to change someone else. Someone's not pushing beliefs on someone else anymore. Someone is just accepting someone for who they are. So if you tend to be a perfectionist, it seems like you might find peace with it in 2022. Maybe with yourself too. And therefore you find more love for yourself. And that allows you to have more happiness in your life and truly fulfillment. Let's look at your cards, shall we? Okay, I kind of want to use the mystical healing reading cards for the Ten of Cups. Let's see. Let's dive a little bit deeper here. As free as the bird, as free as the wind, I'm hearing. Love your body. What did we say, right? Love. So, as you all know, you hear it all over again, everywhere. It starts with self-love, so we can love others around us. Let's talk about this card. It's very straightforward. Your physical appearance might be changing in 2022. You might be more drawn to taking care of your health, focusing maybe on workouts, doing something in order for you to feel good. And especially, I'm seeing muscles, to feel strong in your body. If there is a weak spot in your body, it seems like you're finding a way how to deal with it, how to improve it, what to give to your body in order for you to feel stronger. It's a lot to do with the strength and stamina for you in 2022. You're like, fuck it, you know, whatever is difficult, throw it at me. I can deal with that. You're very determined. You have very strong energy about you. And some of you might be short-tempered. But that's the passion in you, I'm hearing, okay? As long as you're not hurting anyone else. But it's like you want things to happen here and now. Or maybe you did in the past. And now you're becoming a little bit better at that. But whatever the case, your cards are saying, I gotta get shit done. Regardless of any obstacles in my life in 2022, I'm gonna get it done. Discipline and routine is something that you are improving in, something that I'm seeing a fire, and I'm seeing you putting wood in a fire for it to keep going, okay? So what you set your mind to, you're going to do whatever it takes in order for it to happen. Very determined people. Let's see. Scusa. 21. This is card 21. Let's talk about your body. You know what I heard? the song by Lady Gaga, Do What You Want With My Body. That song, I don't know, maybe there is something in it for you. It says, how do you feel about your body? Do you constantly critique it? Or do you listen to it and lovingly nourish and cherish it? Any consciously or unconsciously harbored feelings of self-repulsion, rejection, frustration, anger, and guilt will start to weaken various parts of your body. Maybe you guys are paying attention to your emotions more and how those emotions that are being repressed influence your physical body. And therefore, you're like, okay, let's work on the emotions. That's why I have 10 of cups. Let me do something that I'm happy about today and let's see how I feel about it. You are being asked to tune in and work on creating a healthy inner environment. What if you could see your physical body as the most incredible, divine, perfectly designed part of you, a place that houses your soul? From that perspective, what food, drink, thoughts, feelings, even relationships would you entertain? When you let go of the painful traumatic experiences that have caused you to feel unsafe, start to create healthy boundaries and begin to understand more about your divine nature, your body will become stronger, healthier, and more beautiful. You know this already. This is a reminder, pile number two. Let's talk about some things here. So we're going to be using the triple goddess tarot for you guys. And let's talk about your first card, which is called Rich. Let's see, what do we need to know about this luxury here for 2022? What do we need to know? Straight away pentacles, like, hello, I'm here. Eight of wands, six of wands, wow, wow, wee, wow. Queen of swords, bottom of the deck. Let's see what we got here. The judgment. Let's clarify the judgment. Let's see what it wants to say. What do you want to say for pile two? Knight of swords. Okay. Wow, I love that. I just heard that. You willingly going to put yourself in situations that require you to speak up or to be visible. And that somehow is influencing your material world. See, the way I'm looking at this Eight of Wands, I feel like this is you. In the past, I feel like you were a person who somehow it feels like you've been hiding in the shadows. In 2022, you're coming out of those shadows. You know what needs to be done in order for you to be successful. But we're talking about the financial success here, okay? You know what needs to be done. I told you, very determined. You're like, okay, so how can I go about this situation or matter cleverly? Work smart, not hard. Let me send an email to this person. Let me send an email to this company. They don't know me. I have nothing to do with them. I'm just gonna check if they are looking for a person in their company. And this is not just any company. I'm giving you a company as an example, okay? It's not just any company you are sending this message to. You're the one who's grabbing opportunities here, okay? You're like, I know I can get there. As long as I speak, as long as I make myself visible, as long as I'm literally hearing this, as long as I am in people's ears, there's something to do with being heard here. So for example, why I said it's not just any company. If someone was trying to be, to build their career in fashion, right? They wouldn't send an email to, let's say, apply to be a visual in H&M. They'd send an email, even if they have no experience. Okay, let's start with that. They'd send an email straight to Prada. See what I mean? You it's saying go by that, because 2022, it's all about trying and testing. And you're opening yourself up to that, and therefore, there is going to be a lot to be gained from this. We're not shy in 2022. We shouldn't be shy in 2022. That's what these cards are telling you, in case you are. Okay? We're realizing what we need to wake up to, and there is a lot to do with what you say, how you speak, what action you take. You're willingly asking for the judgment to walk in your life. That's how you feel like to me. You're like, okay, come at me. I might need this now. I need this wake-up call. I want to be shaken up a little bit, because I want to keep going. And whatever you're doing, it seems like it's bringing you a lot of success here. Your determination and willingness not to give up, as well as being somehow visible, either on social media or, I don't know, in many different ways, being heard, is bringing you a lot of success. Let's continue the story. Oh, okay, sorry. I've been told to use the Urban Tarot, so let's do that. Let's see. Pile number twos. What is going on? Of course, Nine of Pentacles. Chilling with your luxuries. See what I mean? So you guys are very focused on independence, on your businesses, or maybe you are creating or building a new business of some sort. But I feel like this is passed over and done with, to be honest with you. It feels like 2022, you are... I'm seeing someone putting money in their wallets, and you're like, okay, I have enough for this, I have enough for that, and I also have enough money to go on holiday for a month. Okay, that's the vibe. I'm not exaggerating, because you have the Rich card and you have the Six of Wands card. Don't come at me. Come after this. Okay. Literally, and the Ten of Cups here. Let's see. You might have an opportunity to travel more than before in 2022. I don't know if it's to do with restrictions or if it's to do with money. That you couldn't do it as much in the past, but it feels like in 2022, there are a couple of trips that are on the horizon. It's up to you if you'll want to take them, obviously. You have the Prince of Swords here again, so we have it twice. It's all about action. 2022 for you is all about action. Whatever, I don't know, I'm going to figure out. See, do you remember how I said you're in people's faces and you need to be heard? See the hacker? He's not very shy. He's like, I need to figure something out. I'm going to figure something out, okay? So you're very determined to get to where you want to be. Some of you might be going about the situation in a sneaky way. Right? Taken from the hacker card. Let me creep on this. Let me see how they do it. I mean, inspiration is always great, right? Just make sure whatever you're doing, you are the product or the service is you. Okay, let's see. With the hacker card, I also want to say someone might find you very interesting because you are shining bright in 2022. So make sure you watch out for, you protect your private matters, okay? Especially when it comes to tech. So just something to remember. Okay. So that the information doesn't get leaked or someone's idea doesn't get stolen. Stuff like that, you get me. Okay, let's see. This is a different story here. Let's see, what is that about? I feel like this is a going with the Two of Wands. You're trying to make a decision about, let's see. You're also trying to make a decision about about what? Interference. Double eight. Okay, might be important. You guys might not want to spend time watching what is said on the news. I feel like most of you are not doing that anymore. But there is something, it's something not necessarily the news, the screen itself. It feels like you want to be off screen. You're visible yourself, but when it comes to screens like scrolling the phone or watching too much Netflix, you will want to be off the screen. For a couple of you, if you're working in a job that requires you to stare at the screen all day, it seems like you are trying to figure out what you want to do about it. There is change coming when looking at the screen yourself, right? Because I see you behind. I'm seeing you on the actual screen, not staring at it for too long, because it somehow, it doesn't balance you. It's an imbalance for you. And maybe those who do not like working on laptops or computers for too long, you might be questioning how to change things around. How can I do things differently? Is there another way? Can I time it? Right? There's something to do with that. Mm-hmm. And Two of Wands is saying you're trying to make up your mind here. What is too much? Victory, twice. Six of Wands, twice here. You guys are big achievers, pile number two. Okay, you're big achievers. For some of you, I'm feeling this might be something to do with hospitality or food that you are great at or you're succeeding at. For others of you, I feel like this is something to do with social media, even family matters for a couple of you, or people's relationships. Maybe you're talking about, maybe you're giving examples, maybe you're talking about what makes, how you found the happiness. What is happiness to you? Maybe you talk about the journey and you're being heard. But your talents and abilities are shining in 2022. And it's because you're unstoppable. We talked about that, right? Whatever it takes, I'll get there. See, this Six of Wands, she's definitely have been on a journey. We don't even know for how long she's been running, right? It's a marathon. You're running a marathon in 2022. Like, F walking. It's marathon now. Let's go. Let's get to the finish line. You're very determined. I don't know what specific goal this is for you. We have art card pop up, which is a temperance in the regular deck. For some of you, this could be something creative. You're doing things differently here. See, that's why you're succeeding. Or this could be, you could be doing things differently from others, how others do things, or it could be, because you've changed structure in your work. You're like, okay, that didn't work for me. That didn't take me to where I want to be fast enough. Therefore, let's change it up. Let's acknowledge what is the interference for me. Let's get rid of indolence, right? Too many coffees, right? Way too many coffees or whatever this person has been drinking. And let's get my shit together. But you're pretty stoked about something here, apart from your success, because I feel like there is something else. There is something else. What is your heart happy about with the Ten of Cups? Your health might be improving, or your finances. This is a very double, you know, this message in this deck specifically, I always take it as both, to be honest. If you have been worried about your health or someone else's health, it seems like, because we clarified in Ten of Cups, you're not anymore. If you've been worried about your finances, let me tell you, we already figured this out. You have the Rich card, Nine of Pentacles. What else do you want? You're definitely stepping out of a chapter of lack, and you're stepping into a very fresh chapter. When I split the deck, we have the Fool. Definitely a fresh chapter, pile number twos. What a pile, man. What a pile. Anything else that we might to know about? What to avoid or what to watch out for in 2022? It's saying pay attention to who you work with or who you collaborate with, okay? Just keep an eye on your coworkers, on your even clients, I would say, right? Because it's teamwork in a way. Feel who you want to work with, who you want to talk to, what job you want to take on. Your intuition will know. Pile two, okay? As long as it's something that feels right, energetically right, okay? Because we can feel energy. Let's see. Yeah, you guys, your health is improving here too, as well as your finances. This is great to see. Yeah, because someone's getting rid of some kind of habit here. Anytime I see this eight of cups, it's like, okay, I'm done and over with this. I'm not doing that anymore. Because, see, I don't know how visible it is on the screen, on your screen, I mean. But there are tarot cards here. And this person is doing something very different from that. There's some kind of a hobby, maybe that's gonna turn to a business here. It has a lot of potential. But someone is putting a lot of effort in this, and it seems like it's been a journey already. And in 2022, you're able to see the fruit of labor and more with the rich card, okay? You could also meet someone who's super, super influential, pal, too. Who is a rich person or who's very well off, and maybe through connections, because you speak in your mind, you see, you're all about communication that takes you places, and you're listening as well what others have to say. There's a good balance between those two. You're able to find connections that take you even further. So keep your eyes open, okay? Live your passions, live your extra life. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now. Hello, hello, pal three people. So I don't know if you heard me in the intro or not. The main idea of this reading is to look at what you might need to hear about for 2022, because there is so much stuff happening throughout the year, right? So I hope this is going to be helpful. And for you guys, instead of two ʤ𝒊𝒊𝒉 tarot cards, I wanted to pull three. So there might be a reason for it. We'll see why. Let's dive into this. So the card that you have here is a soul connection. Then you've got judgment. Then you have the Fool majors, man. Fool. And you have the Queen of Swords. Wow, wow, wee, wow. Let me just sit with these cards. What I'm hearing straight away is that you guys are trying to find answers about one specific connection in your life that you have. Could it be romantic, platonic, doesn't really matter. But you have some kind of a wake-up call in 2022 about it. And it seems like you will want to speak about it, you will want to figure it out, you will want to get more information about it. You're very focused on your intelligence, on your knowledge in 2022. You are not beaten around the bush, and maybe it's somehow connected to this connection, or maybe it's something else. We're gonna look into this, but you're definitely very straightforward, or more straightforward than you were before. It's a year for you about speaking what's on your mind, because I feel like some of you guys have been kind of keeping something inside and not talking about some things. Maybe you tend to be closed off, or maybe that's something that is specific, and in 2022 you'll want to resolve it. You're like, okay, I gotta be open about this. I gotta say as it is. Let's see. For you, I'm gonna be using the Game of Thrones tarot. So let's dive into this card that's called Soul Connection here, and let's see what it wants to say. What do we need to know for pile three about this soul connection? Okay. You have the King of Swords. told you, it's all about communication. You have the Queen and the King of Swords together. Jeez, cards on the floor. Wait, give me a moment. Strength. Let me come back. Okay. Strength. I'm seeing two tough people. Two very intelligent, tough people. So you might be meeting them, or you might be resolving some maybe issues you've had in the past regarding this connection. We have the Page of Coins. We have the Two of Spears. Let's clarify the King of Swords. Let's see what else we need to know about this. This feels more so like a partnership that is not romantic, but it doesn't have to be. I'm saying it doesn't feel like it's not romantic. We're clarifying the King of Swords with Four of Coins. We have Page of Coins here. We have Strength as well as the Queen of Swords. So whatever this connection is, it seems like, see, the king and the Queen of Swords, these are not people who are very emotional. So maybe you're trying to resolve something. Maybe there is lack of emotion in one aspect in your relationship. Maybe it's needed, right? For those who are not in connections of any sorts, it feels like it's talking about some kind of maybe business partner or someone who is going to be quite influential in 2022. Whoever this person is, it seems like they really like stability. This is someone who, I'm not getting the vibe that they like changes that much. For you in 2022, there is some kind of change that's happening here that's almost like an aha moment. And it kind of shifts you towards new energy, which is nice to see because you're becoming a little bit more lighthearted. You know, you're becoming, you want to play more. Okay, you don't want to be serious all the time. You want a better balance with your professional life as well as your inner child, if that makes sense. You want to play more, you want to be lighthearted, you want to learn how not to take things as seriously as you were before. And it's great to take things serious, don't get me wrong, but it seems like for some of you have been it's all about serious stuff and no play. And you will have an opportunity to come out and play more in 2022, which is nice. And now, this might be a situation where these two people, either they shift towards slightly different paths. We'll see what happens, because with the Two of Spears, it seems like someone's looking towards the future here. And intuitively, I do feel like the paths split. Maybe life happens. Let's see. Someone's changing. This either you or this is the other person. Someone is changing, and once they change, they require different things. They want different things. Someone's perception is changing on some kind of a soul contract. Yeah, look, we have the Eight of Cups. I told ya. See? Someone's like, okay, I have to walk my own path now. And it's time for me to say bye. So someone might be leaving your life, or you might be leaving someone's life here. Let's see why. What is happening? Let me get more information. There is distance between two people. Maybe someone has to go somewhere. I don't know what's the situation. Okay, so someone wants to do better. Someone wants to succeed in something here. Therefore, they're like, okay, I gotta go to take care of this stuff. Or I gotta chase my passion. Or I got to, you know, be true to myself, what I want. And right now I want something that might put us on different paths or might somehow separate us. Does that make sense? I hope it does. Because it feels like this, it doesn't feel like it's news here though, pile number two, sorry, three. It feels more so like that's something that maybe you had a feeling about. It feels quite present, whatever the situation is. So since you're all on different time frames slightly in this tribe, maybe this is something that you already experienced, that separation of some sorts. Let's see, what else do we need to know about this? The moon. Okay. Maybe your dream has said something to you here. Yeah, eight of spears, a message. Messages and dreams might be coming around that time. Or around that time when you meet this person, if you haven't just yet, you might start focusing on your future. Start kind of, you know, analyzing what you want to do, what you're seeking for. Maybe you have a new idea on your mind. Maybe you're seeking for some kind of recognition here, and you're like, okay. And by doing so, I feel like we're becoming a bit more distant. What is the advice here? What is the advice here? Okay, for some of you, it seems like it's saying this. It doesn't have to be either black and white. You can juggle two things at once, or someone is juggling two things at once in order to make it work. Chasing for their passion or whatever recognition that they want to go for, and at the same time trying to make it work. But you know, that's something that you want to do or you don't. It's completely up to you, have free will. Or maybe that's someone else who's thinking about it. Yeah, because love is still there. Or, you know, I care for you, still there. Even if it was a business partnership. You know, even if we have to separate in different, you know, maybe sections or different branches, I still care for you. So anytime you need advice or you need help, call me. Right? So we still keep it going somehow here. So it might have been, it might be stretched. You know, it might not be a very straightforward a situation here, because it feels like whatever this is, it's still going to be lingering for some time. Yeah, look at the King of Spears here in this deck. See, it seems like he's in his head. He's like, what do I think about it? What do I do? I'm being pushed and pulled between two things. Someone is being pushed and pulled between two things here. I don't know how to deal with this. Let me think about it. Let me sit down. Let me chill, right? Let me chill. Someone is in their thoughts, in their feels, in their thoughts, missing someone. There's an energy of feeling that you're missing someone, or maybe someone is missing you here. And I'm also hearing what we created. Okay? So let's look at the, I feel like the Fool and the Judgment talk about the same story. So let's continue here and let's see, what do you need to know about 2022? What does this Fool card want to say? Four of Swords, the Hermit. Wow, someone wants more peace. So it feels like you're stepping into a phase in your life where there is more peace, where you might want to explore yourself a little bit more. You want to explore and know yourself deeper. Some of you might find some sort of healing technique that helps you very much, that kind of calms you down or allows you to feel more energized, to charge you up. For some of you, this could be connected to an emotional turmoil of some sort, that you need, and you're saying, now is the time for me to take care of this. Now is the time for me to look deeper. Now is the time to get over some kind of grief, right? You're very focused on your well-being here. And you're also very selective when it comes to who walks with you at certain phases in your life. But it feels like it's a very well-balanced selection. It's not to say that someone's coming from ego, you know, like, ah, you don't have this, you don't have that, F this connection, you have nothing to offer, right? No, it's not like that. It's more like, I sat there for a while, you know? I've been observing this for a while. I feel like I need more peace. I need to dive deeper to understand who I am. And maybe once you understand who you are and what you truly want, organically, naturally, some connections will drift away. Okay. Yeah, you're very focused on your peace, man. It's a very important time for you. And it feels like it's talking about 3 to 5 months time frame here in 2022. Okay. Let me talk about judgment. What do you want to say? Let me talk about judgment. Let's see. For some of you, your relationships with mother figure are changing. Okay, the dynamic of it. Something is shifting here. Someone realizes something about the dynamic they had between the mother and themselves, or the mother figure and themselves. Something was hurtful in the past. I told you, you're very focused on your own well-being, on your emotions, how to process them in order for you to be, to have more peace within. And since you're focusing on your emotions, you then shifting towards the energy of, I feel like some of you have very, very strong, you're very resilient, but you have walls up due to the past pain. And in 2022, you're realizing that maybe sometimes I really need to tune into my heart a bit more in order to be more open to what's to come. Instead of being fearful, I am being open. Yeah, and that's when you shift things around. Let's clarify the Three of Swords. Let's see what it talks about here. You also coming across a piece of information that you didn't know about. There is something that's being revealed about family I'm seeing here that may have an impact on you. Someone might say something you have no clue about, and it makes you think. I'm hearing what goes around comes around as well. I'm seeing a puzzle. And you're solving the puzzle. It seems like 2022 is the year for you when you're able to put things in places. Order is important. Structure, order, but it's not as much to do with, you know, structure and order in work as much it's to do with your priorities. You're like, okay, what do I prioritize right now? What's important to me? And once you have that in place, it feels like you feel much calmer and more peaceful. If you go in against yourself, the more you resist an emotion or facing a past issue or emotion that's repressed, the more you resist it, the more it chases after your ass. You probably noticed that already, right? And in 2022, you're being asked to face some kind of fear here with this card specifically. Okay, look, maybe something that you made a big deal, but it wasn't that big of a deal. For some of you, it will be a big of a deal. But look at the Judgment card over here in this deck. See? It seems like something is being made bigger than it actually is. But there is also a chance, since we have a lot of water, a chance to release some sort of emotion that does not belong in our energy fields anymore. It's over and done with. It's in the past. Let's process it. Let's release it. Let's find peace with it. So since we're talking about deep stuff for pile number three, let me pull from the Black Mirror deck and let's see what this is about. I hope I have a book with me. I'm gonna find it. If not, I'll run to another room and I'll get it. Okay, let's see. What are we releasing here in 2022? What are we finding peace with? Hiding your true self. Wow. Something in your family might have influenced you in a way that made you maybe sometimes hide yourself or not show yourself fully. Sorry, I'm just looking for the book. And you're like, no, actually, I'm gonna pull from this deck too. Bear with me. And you're like, I don't want to do that anymore. I feel like I haven't lived fully because I'm hiding that part of myself or those parts of myself. Now it comes up to number five too. It's time to live fully. It's time to experience life. It's time to experience joy and freedom and to release and feel relieved.
let me just pull one more card and I'm gonna go and grab the book. What is improving for pile number three? What is improving? Trigger statement says their opinion matters to me. Purification, letting go. We talked about this. True statement, I see things in a new way. Yeah, your perception is changing big time. As you release external influences and energy, you will become clear with regard to what is needed. I feel like there is one more card that wants to come out. Let's let gravity do the work. Enlightened. Wow. Doesn't this card go very well with a judgment card? Hey, trigger statement, I am alone. True statement, I am one with all that is. Dear child, you are safe and loved as you continue on your journey of self-exploration, which surely you are onto in 2022. Something might trigger this self-exploration. Something might happen in order for you to shift towards self-exploration and being more open how you express yourself and your emotions. For others of you, you might come across some type of healing or therapy or whatever it is for you that you're like, damn, that's actually great for me. I feel so much more peaceful. I now know where before maybe I didn't even want to dive deep into it. So bear with me. I'll be back in a second. I'll grab the book. Well, no wonder I have so many decks. I cannot find the booklets. I got it. Okay, let's see. Number 14. Alright, dear. So it says, hiding your true self. Hiding is keeping things inside. Lack of trust becomes lack of hope. So there must be a limit. A visual seed. In the dazzling light, there is a hint of a door, like the door to a hammam. Outside, draped in scarlet tunics, stand two women, one under the sign of the sun and the other beneath the sign of the moon. Sentence. You could be in front of the mirror, or you could be behind the mirror, yet you chose to be the mirror. Hiding is a survival instinct. Do you want to be honest and truly be yourself? Very few people will accept you then. You are too complicated to be comfortable, too contradictory to be easy, too exceptional to be believed, too plain to be considered. You can be the sun, you can be the moon, you can be the door, you can be the road, you can be the butterfly and the brick. Maybe the question is not if, but when. Sometimes real solitude is when there is not a right moment to be yourself and not the right person. And neither the right way. Being yourself is like a moment at the spa. It is a massage for the soul, a purification process that brings in oxygen and turns away age and wear. It is bliss and pleasure. This is gonna be a strong year for you all, hey? To truly show yourself for who you are, if you know, you know. It's a very, very strong year. I just want to see what's helping you show your authenticity, or what could help you to show your authenticity more. Let's see. And I'm using the mystical healing reading cards. Let's see. Temper your criticism. Maybe you saw the too much of a criticism when you are growing up, or you tend to criticize yourself too much, and that would be super helpful on your journey. So let's see. And that's why, you know, stepping into the energy of the fool. I told you, remember in the very beginning, you're very clever people, but you tend to be maybe sometimes too serious because you tend to criticize yourself. And maybe when we talk about the mirror, then you criticize other too. And there's almost like feeling like you are in a box and you want to be released and you want to make mistakes and not to judge yourself. And you want to feel freedom within, as well as exploration and just being like F it, let's see what happens. I'll get up and go again, you know, if I fall. But there's some kind of shackles maybe that keeping you away from that freedom. And what you're doing here by going within, by looking maybe at your past, you're realizing what has influenced you and you're breaking free. Pile number 33. See that? Okay, let's talk about this. It says, by the way, you can look at the image and you can pick up symbols or messages for yourself if you want to get lost in the image as I'm reading this. Become discerning instead of critical. When you are critical, you harden yourself and literally put energetic knives into others. You also block yourself from becoming a more refined, sensitive, intuitive human being. Your healing pathways get blocked and your bones and muscles begin to degenerate. When you are harsh and critical with yourself, you lose your life force energy, your self-esteem, and you become depressed. Your ability to be flexible, think deeply, and receive new, higher wisdom is also limited. Start looking for what is good, which you are doing in 2022, right? Holy and beautiful in each person. Develop discernment whilst still encouraging yourself and others to grow. Try to see things from several angles in order to create more objectivity and gentleness in your counsel. Practice self-kindness. This card asks that you start to experience yourself, others, and the world from a more compassionate point of view. Look at every challenge as a possibility for growth. So, pile number 3. What a reading, man. What a strong reading. I hope this made sense, and I'm going to catch you in the next one. Bye for now.